our lives and everything we do and that we say. Hallelujah. He said he allowed Christ. Everything was under his feet. So he said we can trample. We can stand upon the serpent. We can destroy the serpent. He said he bruised him with the heel of his feet. But we can walk on the coals of fire. And yes, and not be burned. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We thank you, Lord. And he said he had gave him to be head over all things to the church. Dominion and authority. When we walk in humility and we die to the things that are not kingdom. Thank you, Lord. Which is his body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all.
I have an observation. When he talks about that he put him in the right side, he's on the right side of the cross.
Yes.
He's saying that he is in a place of authority.
Yes.
He's a place of honor.
Hallelujah.
And he's a place of kingdom.
Yes.
And that if God, if Jesus is in that place,
yes,
we have that same blessing that will bestow upon Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
But because of ignorance of the relationship we have in Christ, we always consider that we are to be in this earth to suffer.
Yes.
And we don't realize that we're in this earth to experience.
Yes.
The blessing that Jesus experienced,
yes,
after he already made the sacrifice.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of people is teaching us that you have to suffer, you have to suffer, you have to suffer, you have to suffer. Because
yes,
Christ suffered, you
yes,
got to bear the cross.
That's
he already
right,
bear the cross.
Yes.
He already took that place. He didn't want you to be another sacrifice lamb.
Yes.
He wanted to experience his glory.
Yes.
But it's taught a lot,
yes,
that we as Christians, we have to suffer, we have to suffer. So people have a question about why coming into this kingdom realm when all is it about suffering.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not what Christianity is all about. He wants us to walk in what? In his grace and his mercy. And according to that, we are heirs of the blessings. Not the curse. He don't want us to walk in the curse. But a lot of Christians walking in the curse because they don't know what this scripture just talked about. We have the power to acquire wealth. But when we talk about wealth, we're talking too much about the monetary wealth.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot more type of wealth than money. Health is wealth.
Yes.
Being alive is wealth.
Yes.
Being able to sleep is wealth.
Yes.
Being able to have peace is wealth.
Mm-hmm.
Because all of these things involve accomplishment.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody think about it is the mansion, the car, the house. But many people have that and don't have peace.
Mm-hmm.
It's better to have peace than to be wealthy,
mm-hmm,
financially,
mm-hmm,
and not being able to sleep.
Yes.
Some people have money and can't eat.
Yes.
So to me, all of those little things is blessing. And like I said before, we are looking for miracles, but we're looking for great miracles. And we don't realize that every day we wake up, that's a miracle in itself. And because we're looking for something that's already here, we miss it. We keep missing it because we're still looking. Where is this great tornado? Where is this great separation of the ocean? Where is this great bringing back to life? But when you pray for somebody and they heal, that's a miracle in itself.
Yes.
But we're still looking for the great thing, and that's why we're missing the little things. Amen?
Hallelujah. Pastor, will you read chapter 2, beginning with the first verse?
And you had the quickened. Were dead in trespasses and sins, wherein time past you walk according to the course of this world, and according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. So that's why so much things is going on, because we're not recognizing who is the prince of the air.
Yes. Hallelujah. And then he's allowing us to know that We're not who we used to be. Because when we say, okay, Father, I accept who you are. I accept you as my Savior. And then we allow him not only to be Savior, but we allow him to reign in our lives
Amen.
As Lord.
Amen.
Meaning I don't just give you a little bit of me, but I submit every area and aspect
Amen.
Of my life to you. Then we are filled with new life.
Amen.
And we have the blessings of the kindness of God through his love.
Amen.
Through patience, hallelujah. And it's an eternal gift of God to us.
Mm-hmm.
What a gift.
Mm-hmm.
What a gift.
And I believe that as humans, we fail to give God the minimum requirement.
Mm-hmm.
Praise.
Yes.
Praise. That's what he said. Delight what? In the praises of his people.
Yes.
But we don't want praise.
Yeah.
We want, but we don't want praise.
And see, individually, many of us, we haven't sought to know. It's just like driving a car. Say if I get a Lexus and I never look at the manual, I never try to find out anything about that car, but I'm now the owner
mm-hmm.
of that car. I have no knowledge whatsoever
mm-hmm.
of why it was created or, you know, or how it's really supposed to function. Do you think I'm going to be able to drive that car?
Mm-hmm.
Because I got to learn how to operate everything that is on the inside of it. But if I never choose to seek out the instruction, and it's the same with us being the created of Christ, we have to know what we originated from. What was the purpose? You know? And without that, and then, you know, individually, and then corporately, just as the created of God. We don't realize that we are one body.
Yep.
But in this chapter, this is what it allows us to know. Even in a little bit that you have read in this first verse, we'll learn that we are members of one body with this dealing with the second chapter.
Mm-hmm.
One body. And even though it's a full body with different members, the eyes,
mm-hmm.
the nose, the ears, the mouth, you know, you got the head, you got the neck, your shoulders, the arms, and all these different things. And there's things that connects everything.
Amen.
Because guess what? If something isn't connected, it has no function.
Amen.
But keep going.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Among whom also we all had our conversation in times past, in the lust of our flesh,
mm-hmm.
fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace you are saved.
Now, who is the prince of power?
The devil.
Okay, now, with knowing this, it says, wherein in time past you walked according to the course of this world. What was the course of the world?
The course of the world is following in the way of Satan.
Mm-hmm.
This way, we are delighting, most of us delight ourselves in the ways of Satan.
Mm-hmm.
Because it make it what? It make it appealing, right? Everything world is appealing.
Mm-hmm.
You never see an ugly apple. Because if the apple is ugly, nobody want to eat the apple. So you have to make it appealing.
Yes.
Sin is attractive.
Hello.
Sins make things attractive. Whatever is ugly, it makes it pretty.
Yes.
And that's why we fall, because it makes it look. See, God is about the truth.
Yes.
But Satan uses the same truth and twist it in
right.
order to make it more delightful, more
mm-hmm.
appealing.
Exactly.
See, Satan don't got no new trick.
Yes.
And Satan don't got no creation.
Okay.
He have to use what is available
mm-hmm.
and use it in a way that it appeals to us, our desire.
And so, with that being said, the course of the world is sin.
Mm-hmm.
simple, one word, it's sin.
And it's made appealing because man like instant satisfaction. Mm-hmm. That's what we like. Mm-hmm. We like instant satisfaction. The flesh don't like to wait. It wants it now. It's just like a baby. When a baby wet, he wants you to change him. When he's hungry, he wants you to feed him. If you make him stay long enough, he will make your life miserable. Because he wants you to know, I ain't going to stay in this mess. You clean it up.
Okay, well, our dear beloved pastor has covered our next few verses.
Oh, I did?
Before we got to them.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Well, let me just read in the comments.
Yeah, go ahead.
Even when we were dead in sins, how quickening us together with Christ by grace you are saved.
Mm-hmm.
And I raised up us together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
So we got the same blessing that Jesus had.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
So why are we walking in so much poverty and so much lack?
Because of our mindsets. And again, if you don't know the purpose or you choose not to, if the seed is sown into you and you're given knowledge,
mm-hmm.
to ponder upon it, that he's able to reveal, which is revelation,
mm-hmm.
reveal the knowledge that you allow it to come alive on
mm-hmm.
the inside of you,
mm-hmm.
to know the very character and nature of who Christ is,
mm-hmm.
you're at a standstill.
Yeah, waiting for something that's right there.
Yes.
Ready to reach.
There's no vision.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's why the word says that the eyes of the understanding would be enlightened. So it's just like a blind person, you know, when they have the scabs and you got different degrees of, you know, them being able to see.
Right.
Some of them, the cataracts are so thick, they can't see
mm-hmm.
anything. Then you have some that have a little light film.
Mm-hmm.
They have some knowledge and they choose a little bit
mm-hmm.
to operate in what, you know, the Word of God have told us to do.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like, no, you know, and I choose not to receive this, or I have not pursued
mm-hmm.
any further to learn anything more.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have some where the word says how the seed is sown. They'll hear the word
mm-hmm.
and, you know, allow their hearts to be hardened because
mm-hmm.
I just want to do what I want to do.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the pride of my life. I don't want to be told what to do. I'm enjoying what I'm doing.
That's
what you know,
word.
And you know, let me be. God knows who I am. He knows I'm not perfect. Well, I'm a sinner. I'm a die sinner. You know. Then you have some walking with Christ. Well, he knows I'm not perfect. You know, and he knew I was gonna sin before I sinned. But this is where Paul says to us: do we say because of grace away with the law?
Mm-hmm.
Not so.
Mm-hmm.
So because I have the grace of God, am I just going to say, well, God knows I was going to go out there and sin,
mm-hmm.
so let me go out there and steal, let me go out there and continuously lie myself down, or be a gossiper, or, you know, murder, or whatever. Because God knows I'm going to do this. And, you know, he'll forgive me. He's a forgiving God. And we say that God, he's not supposed to be angry.
Mm-hmm.
That he doesn't punish. But that is not so. David said, I'd rather fall in the hands of an angry God than men.
Mm-hmm.
So the word allows you to know that, yes, God can get angry.
Oh, yeah.
And that is why the word says that vengeance is whose?
Wow.
Exactly. He tells us to be angry, but sin not. That's why the law of sowing and reaping is, it is so vital for us to know about.
It's nothing but the truth.
Exactly. And the seeds that we sow, no matter the type of seed, we shall reap a harvest. Hallelujah. Go ahead.
I was about to say this part. We a lot of us are upset with technology. We start upset with the internet and the computer. But you know what? Science is never going to stop until the end of it.
Yes.
And in the science advancing, the word of God come out to be true.
Mm-hmm.
Every tongue shall confess.